Okay, thank you. I am Dr. Antoine Dara from MRTC. I joined Dr. Jimde's lab at MRTC 15 years ago as a student, actually to complete my PharmD dissertation, which was focused on comparing two molecular techniques to monitor drug resistance. So upon graduation, I actually decided to continue working on malaria. We focus on malaria resistance and malaria pathogenesis using DNA microRNA tools. Then in 2012, I was actually recruited as an assistant professor at the Faculty of Pharmacy. The same year, I started a program in molecular microbiology and immunology, actually a program that was a PhD program at the University of Maryland. And this was under the supervision of Dr. Plow and Joanna Silva. So this was the same university where actually Professor Jimde did his PhD, also under the mentorship of Dr. Plow. So my PhD work was based on developing tools, mainly bioinformatics algorithm, to assemble a complex gene family of the malaria parasite, Plasmodium falciparum, known as VAR genes. And these are actually genes that are involved in the malaria pathogenesis. And studying these important genes have been very challenging because of the diversity and the complexity of these genes. From this work, I published two papers as first author. And after my graduation, I took a year postdoc at the same university where I worked with Dr. Plow. Dr. Plow trainees, which was Dr. Miriam Lofer and along with Dr. Joanna Silva. So my postdoc work over there was actually the follow-up of my PhD thesis, and it was actually focused on developing a pipeline to target assemble VAR genes, especially VAR2-CSA, which is associated with placental malaria, using Illumina platform. So after spending 7 years in the US and moving back home, seemed like a big challenge, but in my case, it was very simple. Yet I was well prepared for that even before I started my training over there. So my philosophy has always been to come back home, because home is for me the better place. There are people even more qualified than me in the US. This is so. I say myself, for my PhD to have a full actually advantage, it will be better to actually go back home than staying in the US. So this is because, you know, in the US there are people that are more qualified than me, I would say, actually, to do the same work I have been doing. And then why not going back home? Why not stay there? So in my mind, it was always go back home. And it will be like you will be more useful home, where you can actually teach and share what actually you learn from the US and train a student locally. So the vision and the desire to return home was always fueled by my mentor's vision at the Malaria Training and Research and Training Center in Mali. So our late Professor Dumbo and Professor Jimde have shown to young Malians that it was possible to do research in Mali. So this vision was also called capacity building. And returning to Africa, where you know that you can do research within a well-established research institution, is not always granted. But in Mali, we have this privilege. Upon coming back home, I started a second postdoctoral position under the Delgen program, and my research for this fellowship actually focuses on understanding mechanism of drug resistance and the pathogenesis of severe malaria. So I'm currently using edge-cutting bioinformatics and genomics tools to address my research question, and the finding from this project, I'm convinced that will have important implication for malaria elimination program. So we have been lucky to have actually this training, and I would say thank you to the Delgen program for training young African scientists.